Halo, it's Jang here, back with some more Mega Bloks Halo goodness. These are the first two of the new Halo Wars styles of Cyclopses, and these are sold independently, individually, and separately, but I thought I would just review them together in one video since they came out at one time and they're actually quite very similar. This first one is the Strike Cyclops, and it comes with a basic Marine. I'll show you the figures up close later on. This is an entirely new design for Cyclops. It does not share anything except for the toes with the old design, and as you can see, it completely dwarfs the old design and has way more articulation, as I'll try to demonstrate. This also even dwarfs the height of my custom Cyclops that added a lot of bulk to it, so that's a good thing. It's nice to see the size increase, and they still do allow you to put a figure inside of this. It looks pretty good from most angles. It was a good build. You know, it uses a lot of small pieces that you actually have to put together yourself, whereas the old design really relied upon a certain set of specialized molds. This does have some specialized parts, such as the main chassis, which is buried way deep beneath there. Also, the canopy is a brand new mold. However, I feel like those pieces are really well used and necessary, and there's just so much other stuff that you add on here. It felt like a proper building experience. This particular set here comes with 162 pieces. Incidentally, the other one that I'm going to show you had exactly 162 as well. All the joints here are able to move. So you've got articulation there. You've got a little bit of articulation forward and back at the ankle, but you also have sideways articulation side to side, which is very useful if you're going to splay the legs or move them around. You've got articulation at the hips. You can go way forward, way back. Lots of range there. These are very useful joints. The only thing about them is that you have to be careful not to pull them apart. If you get a little bit of extra friction in there, I think just on average, sometimes these will want to flip out. I'm actually having pretty good luck here, but look at that. You can turn the leg all the way out, a full 90 degrees. You can even turn it around backwards like this if you want to. Some of these armor add-on pieces, little sub-assemblies, are easy to come up. There we go. That's what I was looking for, what I wanted to demonstrate. I didn't mean to do that right there, but that is something to watch out for when you're posing these. You know, the durability for play is not so great, but they do give you just an incredible range of motion. Some of these assemblies can come off easily here and also up here for the shoulder. I found that with this one in particular, it's this angled piece, this bracket piece along the side, 90 degree angle piece, that can tend to come off this way. Now, I did it intentionally there, but sometimes if you're not doing it intentionally, that'll just happen. So again, just something to watch out for. Same type of joint setup for the shoulder. So you can go all the way out, full 90 degrees, maybe just a little bit more, and down. That can be brought forward so you can raise the arm all the way up. Again, watch out for that. That does happen. That's just how it goes. It's the compromise here. I think they could have done a little bit better with those parts, but I do like having the range of motion. The elbow is a little bit limited with the way this is built right now, but you can adjust that. You can either leave out this one piece here in the front, which has just that little bar kind of extension on it, which stops the motion right there, or you can replace that. You can swap that piece out with one of these 1x2 plates from the other side. It'll give you just a little bit more room to flex at the elbow. The hands, oh yeah, and of course at the elbow again, same joints, so you can rotate around like this. The hands, there's that same sort of issue again. The hands have fingers, two fingers and a thumb. You can give a thumbs up look like that. That's actually pretty cool. And you can see that this is on a joint that's able to rotate around, so you can articulate that differently. That's really nice. Just means that you can grab a lot of different types and sizes and shapes of things. And this one on the arm has a machine gun there, which is also built up. You know, you can recognize some of those parts, but it looks pretty good. I think especially if you hold it on there straight, it just looks pretty appropriate. The canopy opens up here from the top, and the whole front of the body opens up to allow you to get access to actually put the figure inside of there. Now there's no canopy to be seen, or no console rather, to be seen from the inside for your figures, but you know, they will fit in there, and I will show you how that looks with the figure fitting inside. Around the back, a little bit of detailing there, and there will be a little bit of difference from model to model. I like these pieces, how they come down and provide some coverage around the sides. These are printed, and see they're not the same, they're actually mirrored. And this is also printed across the top. It's all part of the canopy piece. And the paint application for the kind of visor area is pretty clean. I do wish that there was some translucency to that just a little bit, so you could actually see the pilot inside once you have it in there, but it's okay. It's not bad. The whole thing, though, that's a printed piece there. Small little details around here. It's nicely done. It's really nicely built up. This is the Incinerator Cyclops, and it comes with a Flame Marine, a new, highly articulated, fully articulated Flame Marine. I'll have to take a closer look at that. But yeah, this one, you can see immediately, uses pretty much the exact same build, the same construction. They change out the color scheme, including even the print up here on the top. You know, some whole pieces are changed out, and the back build is just a little bit different. What they add on to it with the canister there very much mirrors the look of the Flame Marine. So they've got the big napalm canister or whatever that's supposed to contain. And then this is the flamethrower itself over on the side on the arm, and it's just attached on there. So you can easily remove that very quickly and easily remove that and just be left with a different color scheme of Cyclops. So it kind of looks like it's, you know, just a red team Cyclops. You can put the gun from the other one on here. I hope they will do a blue one also. Maybe a total of four different colors of these would be really good to go with the multiplayer, you know, aspect of the game. And, you know, opening this up, you see the same thing again, just different colors used. I like the use of the transparent red pieces on the side. Just gives it a little bit of more flamey feeling, but otherwise everything is going to be the same, you know, just minor differences other than the weapon and the figure and the colors, of course. The basic Marine that comes with the Strike Cyclops is basic, you know, nothing too fantastic here. I think it does look really good. That is a good color scheme with the root beer brown and I don't know what you call that, desaturated green color. It's like a dark lichen color. I don't even know what to call it, but obviously this will fit in well with, you know, forest jungle kind of themes, but definitely not with Arctic desert. Maybe a little bit with the brown, but it does end up being dark with all the dark accents on there. Comes with the shotgun there. It's a pretty good looking figure, but it just doesn't stand up to this guy, the new super articulated Flame Marine. Now I have to admit I may be a little bit biased here in favor of this guy, because the old Megablocks Flame Marines were some of my favorite non-augmented human figures that they did, but this one is several cuts above, not just because of the articulation, but the color scheme and how the color scheme can be applied to these. Now they did use the exact same weapon system here. So the same parts were used here. It's one main part for the base, one part for kind of the barrel of the thing, and then one part for the canister on the backpack. Thankfully, they've brought in a silicone hose here, which is much more flexible compared to the old one that was actually probably a similar material, but it was more solid and just more difficult to pose. This one's a lot easier to angle around. You don't have to get it just right to be able to pose this up. Now let me actually take some of this stuff off so you can see the figure underneath. And while we're looking at this, might as well compare it directly to the old model. You see a lot has changed. You know, it is Halo 2, or Halo Wars 2 versus Halo Wars 1, but the old one was just using the same chest plate that they use for so many figures, and the new one just has a lot more detail in it with the armor piece, the visor, and the whole helmet. It's just good stuff. I'm really happy with this. Really, really happy. And I'm looking forward to collecting a full set of these as they come out with more different colors. I'm sure that they'll do more in the future, you know, just like they did before. And look forward to being able to get a whole lineup of them and just have them all next to each other. With the new design of Cyclops, a figure literally just sits in there. It doesn't get attached to the back with kind of a cheater peg to hold it into place or anything. It just sits there. It's best to kind of lean it back and then just bring this forward section in to kind of hold it in place. You can kind of mess around with the exact placement of the legs, but it sits in there just a little bit loose, but you bring this down and he's just pretty well covered in there. From some angles, you can see just a little bit through, you know, a couple of gaps, but it's dark enough in there that you don't really see that much. From directly from the side, if you bring the arms up, you can see the leg there. So that's the spot that has the most obvious gap. But as long as you don't put a figure in here that has really bright colored lower legs, you're not gonna see it that much. And from most angles, you don't see it. It's nice to get a figure in there, you know, properly. And you open this up and that's a good look right there. You know, even though it is able to move back and forth just a little bit, looks like he's in command. You know, it's interesting, when I first saw the hero shot, the main marketing shot for the Strike Cyclops, I was not particularly impressed with the body design. It didn't look aggressive to me. It looked just boxy from that particular angle there. This one doesn't look so bad to me, but in person, the Cyclops, including especially the Strike Cyclops, just looks significantly better to me. It looks more sleek, it looks more aggressive, it looks more futuristic, it looks more mean. So I am actually liking this stuff much better than I did before I got them in my hands in front of me. Some of these, you know, new sets, like last year, will come with rec packs. Some of them won't, and I don't know exactly what the distribution will be there. But I'm happy, really happy with these new designs, really happy to get rid of the old design. It just never worked for me. It was just far too simple. These new ones do not have the greatest durability. They've definitely moved in the direction of the collector market, a little bit older or more mature market. Folks who want to be able to get a lot of posability, and you do lose some integrity along the way, some physical integrity. So, you know, as I showed you, as you pose things, if you're not careful, some things will come apart and you just have to push them back together. Ultimately, you can get just an incredible range of poses with these, but you do have to use a little bit of care. Thanks for watching this review. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll talk to you again soon.